You've just become the proud owner of a RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer. Congratulations! You're about to bring an unparalleled level of color accuracy to your business, ensuring that your customers are always satisfied. By now, you've received your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer. You may have even begun unboxing it. Before you move forward, we strongly advise that you watch this introductory video that will go over proper use, as well as some of the exciting features of the Spectro device. This will help you build the confidence you need to use the Spectro device quickly and efficiently, ensuring your customer walks away pleased with the work you've done. The RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer is capable of an extraordinary range of tasks. In this video, we'll be going over basic use, functionality, and some of the features of the Spectro device, as well as a brief overview of some of the tasks you will be able to perform with the accompanying Paint Manager XI software. But first, let's look at the equipment you've received. Inside the box, you'll see a case. Due to the harsher conditions of a shop, it's strongly advised that you store your XI in this case, or with the accompanying home base add-on accessory if you have one when it isn't in use, as many of the delicate mechanisms within may be damaged by airborne particles. Opening the case, you'll probably notice the Spectro device first. Be very careful not to remove the Spectro device by grabbing it around the sides like this, as you may damage the shutter door. Instead, carefully remove the Spectro device as so. In the near future, you may receive a device with a protective sticker on the bottom. This case adds a protective shell around your device, ensuring that it remains undamaged during opening. Once it's out of the case, you can get familiar and comfortable with the ergonomics and weight of the device. The next item you may notice is this small plastic case. This is your calibration tile set, and it's used to ensure the best readings possible with your Spectro device. Ensure that this case is closed at all times unless this Spectro device is being calibrated. We'll go over calibration later in this video. You will also find a USB card. This is the installer for the RapidMatch XI image collection. Be sure to open the flash drive carefully so you don't accidentally damage it. We'll go over installing the drivers later in this video as well. Also in your case, you have a power adapter, USB cable, and a battery. Be sure to keep the battery charged when not in use for maximum performance time. The USB cable allows you to connect your RapidMatch XI Spectro to the Paint Manager XI software on your computer once readings are complete. Before you use any of the RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer's features, you'll have to install the Spectro's drivers and images. Inside your case, you'll find the USB card that we mentioned earlier. This card will install all of the images and the accompanying information that the Spectro device needs to function properly into the software. Take the USB card and insert it into an available USB slot on your Paint Manager XI computer. Before we continue, ensure that the Paint Manager XI software is completely shut down, as the drivers and image collection won't be able to install if the software is running. Then navigate to the file called PPG Paint Manager RapidMatch Installer and double-click it. At this point, your screen should look like this. The first screen is going over any prerequisites you should be aware of before installation. Select a language from the bottom left, and then go ahead and click Next once you've made sure you're ready for install. The software is now checking your Paint Manager XI server connection and ensuring that you have the PMXI software installed on your machine. Once we have a green check, we're clicking Next again. Confirm that you'd like to install both the Spectro device driver and the images collection. Once both of these are checked, Next once more. The process of installation will now begin. This is the easiest part. Just sit back and wait for the installation to finish. This may take a bit of time, so we'll move forward a few minutes. Feel free to pause this video until you're caught up. And we're done! The installation has completed successfully, and we now have access to all of the images and information in the Paint Manager XI software. Now it's time to connect your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer to your Paint Manager XI server computer. Doing this allows the accompanying Paint Manager XI software to recognize your Spectro and thus recognize readings and prepare jobs. You'll need the USB cable, your Spectro, and your Paint Manager XI computer for this portion of the setup. Connect the Spectro device by inserting one end of your USB into the computer and the other end into the back of the Spectro device. Once this is done, your computer may take a moment to recognize the device. Now all you have to do is tell the software to look for this new device. To do this, we'll go into Settings, Spectro Settings, and then Find Connected Spectro. And there it is. Your software can now recognize this device whenever it's connected. As you unbox and power on your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer for the first time, you may notice a prompt alerting you that it's ready for calibration. If you've dismissed this prompt, don't worry. You can also perform calibration by going into Settings, Calibration. Be sure to use the calibration tile set originally supplied with your spectro, as they are paired together, and other calibration tile sets will not work with your spectro. It's very important to calibrate when your device alerts you, typically only once every 30 days, as this is best practice for acquiring the most accurate readings. Once we've selected Calibrate on the pop-up screen, a short tutorial will appear, showing us the steps to calibrate. Be sure to have your calibration tile set ready before you calibrate. Place the spectro on the tile once you've opened it. Doing so by aligning right along the white lines on both devices and following the three guiding pins is the easiest way to ensure you've done so properly. When you're ready, press the play button at the top right of your device. We will begin taking measurements to ensure that your device is calibrated properly. If you receive an error stating that the calibration failed, that's okay. Just ensure that the calibration tile is clean and aligned properly, and then try again. If, however, your calibration fails a second time, you may need to contact our help desk to have your device inspected. When you've finished calibrating on the white tile, it's best practice to repeat the process on the effect tile side. We'll go more in depth regarding calibration in later videos. Let's move on to surface prep. Surface prep is a critically important part of the measurement process. Without surface prep, dirt, grime, dust, and other hardships a car suffers on the road can change what color your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer is seeing. First, you'll want to pick a flat, dent-free part of the vehicle close to the repair area. As a best practice, PPG recommends buffing the intended area first for the most accurate reading. After that, we'll take a soft cloth, nothing coarse, and wipe down the intended area thoroughly. We don't just want the intended area to be clean, but dry as well. Once you've cleaned the intended area, do a spot check to make sure there are no dust particles or any other obstructions or scratches on the area. Once you've done that, you're ready to take your first reading with your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer. The RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer is designed to be held vertically for all measurements. The main advice we offer is to always use both hands when operating the device so you get a good seal and don't drop it. Hold the device firmly against the surface you're taking a reading on, ensuring you have no light leaks. Your spectro device uses light to take a reading, and any outside light can corrupt your measurement and give you a poor reading. You should also be aware of temperature. An environment that is too hot or too cold can give a false reading, so it's advised that you take your measurements in a temperature-controlled environment. Once you've ensured that you have the right environment and seal, follow the prompts on your spectro device. You may need to adjust the angle you're holding your device, and you should do so carefully so as not to drop it. The arrows and prompts on the screen will direct you until you see all green. If your screen does not have three green dots and a green background, you still need to make certain adjustments before capturing your measurement. You will also need to take five measurements, as prompted by your spectro device. It is considered best practice to take these five measurements in a tight area around the initial measurement point. To capture your measurement, you can press either side of the device, the button at the head of the device, or by tapping the screen itself, depending on how you're holding your spectro and what feels most comfortable. Be sure to save when you're done so that you can upload your readings later. Now it's time to take a look at your readings and discover how to select the best option. Once you connect your RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer into your Paint Manager XI computer via the USB cable we mentioned earlier, we'll take a look at how to select a reading. Head over to your computer, and then the Paint Manager XI software. On the home menu, select RapidMatch. If this is your first time looking at readings, you may not see readings in this list. To upload your reading or readings that you just took, click Download from Spectro, and the list will populate. there are a few methods involved with selecting a match. The Paint Manager XI software uses advanced technology and mathematics to make the best mix match for you, and condenses that information into two measurements. Match rating is the summary of everything related to the color that the device read. If below 10, you should be able to mix and blend with confidence. EC, effect coarseness, is the measurement of the textures in a color, such as the coarseness or fineness of metallic or pearl effects. Knowing this, it's still important to use your own sense of judgment to ensure that the match is a close fit for the color you're trying to replicate. Match rating and effect coarseness are measured differently. Match rating is scored numerically, while effect coarseness is scored with OK, C for coarser, and F for finer. If you have two different matches that are both green-green, it may be tricky to select which match you should use. When this happens, don't worry. You're 99% of the way to selecting a color, and you have a few options. If you have a chip deck, you can pull the colors out and hold them against the vehicle and gauge which one is a better match. If you don't have chips, if available, you can reference the digital images to make a selection. And if there are no pictures available, you can still mix a small sample to test the colors, or simply select the highest item on the list. Remember, a match rating of 10 or less with an OK effect coarseness for metallics, or a match rating of 5 or less for solids, means you can blend with confidence. You can also adjust a match, and this can be done easily by selecting Adjust at the far right of the match information. When you select Adjust from the tool menu, the Paint Manager XI software will calculate the adjustment to move the color closer to the target. The adjustment option is available on match ratings over 10 for metallic and over 5 for solids. Now that you're armed with this light overview of some of the highlights, best practices, and other information regarding your new RapidMatch XI spectrophotometer, you can bring a whole new level of accuracy to your business. Your RapidMatch Spectro and accompanying software is capable of a great deal more than we overviewed today, and we encourage you to read your manual and look for more advanced videos in this series to utilize your Spectro fully.